Hi, I'm Margaret Weitekamp. I'm the chair of the Space History Department here at the Smithsonian's National Air and Space Museum. This is the Close Encounters Mothership model. This is the large model that was used to get the iconic shots from Steven Spielberg's 1977 film, Close Encounters of the Third Kind. Steven Spielberg, the director, he saw a petroleum plant lit up at night and was really captured by that vision of all of those lights in amongst all of those other industrial looking structures. The bottom, as I understand it, comes from him seeing the city lights in California reflected in the hood of his car. Part of the layers of detail that are on this model are something that are called greeblies, which is where you just put a lot of texture on a thing in order to make it look like a real thing. So if you look at your car, if you look at any, if your bicycle, it has bumps, it has ridges, it has things on it that are a part of it being a real thing with parts and pieces and connections. So the way that a model like this is built is that it is hand built of all of these little tiny pieces. The little columns on the top of the model were actually hand rolled by the model makers. But we also know that they just grabbed streetlights from railroad kits and bent them at alien kind of angles and used those to create the spires and the spines that are all around this model. And then the cloud effects that surrounded the model. That was a part of the story in Close Encounters of the Third Kind, that when the alien ships would show up, it would affect actually an almost change in the weather and create clouds that would be around the ships themselves. By creating layers of density with water, they were able to create this look of having paint seem to billow, but then also hit a stopping point and spread out in a way that made it seem, when it was added to the film from the model, like the model itself, the ship itself, was reshaping how the clouds formed around it. As the mothership comes over Devil's Tower National Monument, that large butte out in the American West in South Dakota, all of those pieces needed to be built in order to make this scene. So there's not only the building of the mothership model to depict the alien spaceship, but they also needed to build Devil's Tower and then composite that in with the rest of what was being done to set the scene. The model makers thought that nobody was ever going to see this up close. So in addition to doing all of the very exacting, detail-oriented work of building all of the layers that are what gives this model its final effect on film, they had some fun. So the model makers hid little things in amongst the other details. Here you can even see R2-D2 essentially riding on the edge of the mothership model. Shows up upside down in the actual film. And in fact, there are even two very small, deep inside the model, great white sharks. A little nod to Jaws, which was Steven Spielberg's movie just previous to this. Movie making really builds on itself. When people see things done by another filmmaker, they are trying not only to replicate that, perhaps adopt some of those technologies, but then also build on it. So when you really look into the history of movie making, there's a complex history in the development of cameras, in the development of lights, of special effects. And starting in the 1990s, you then add to that computer-generated imaging and the ability to grab something and alter it, or in fact to draw whole characters with a computer.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.